Jai Shri Gurudev, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is Ravi N, Assistant Professor, Department of Commerce and Management, BGSIMS, Chikbalapur. Dear students, in this video I am going to explain another question under income from business. So here is the question. Let me explain the question first. Compute income from business of Mr. J for the assessment year 2019-20. Profit and loss account as on 31st 3 2019. See, no adjustments is given for this question, only the profit and loss account is given. So in which you need to solve, or in which you need to compute the taxable income from business of Mr. J. Yes, so as we know, under debit side the expenses will be given. In that, admissible, inadmissible expenses as well as net profit will be included. And under credit side, business incomes, non-business incomes and tax-free incomes and gross profit will be included. Okay, so now you have to segregate the expenses into admissible and inadmissible. If admissible expenses is given, ignore it. If inadmissible expenses is given, just consider or add back to add items, add back to net profit, or consider that items in a add items in the solution. Okay, yes. Now let me explain. First, office expenses. So office expenses is admissible. General expenses also admissible. Interest on bank loan is also admissible. Then audit fees admissible. Interest on capital is not admissible. It is inadmissible expenses. So any interest on capital, owner's capital, that is inadmissible expenses. So inadmissible expenses is debited, so that you have to add back to net profit. So net profit ke add madbeku andre add items alli tagobeku anta. So first one is, and next, rent. Rent is admissible. Income tax, it is inadmissible. So inadmissible always the direct tax, any direct tax like income tax, wealth tax, so corporate tax, so any tax, any direct tax is inadmissible. Okay, so this item also add back to the net profit. So to consider this in a add items. And then charity. So charity means donation. So that donation or charity is also a inadmissible expenses, so add back to net profit to consider in add items. And then legal expenses. So legal expenses is admissible. Then compensation to retrenched employee. So retrenched employee, any compensation given to that retrenched employees, so that is a admissible expenses. And then extension of building. Extension of building, it does not relate to a business. Even though it is related to the business, it is considered as a non-business expenditure, which means inadmissible expenditure. So inadmissible expense is debited, so that consider in add items or add back to net profit. And net profit is given, that is 5,36,000, that has to be recorded at the starting in the answer. And then come to a credit side. So we already know credit side, gross profit will be given, and business incomes will be given, and non-business incomes will be given, and tax-free incomes will be given. So in that, you need to ignore gross profit as well as business incomes. If any other non-business incomes and tax-free incomes is given, just you need to consider that items in a less items, or you should deduct those items from net profit. So now gross profit, just ignore the gross profit. And interest on government's securities. So interest on government securities, tax free, so that deduct from net profit. Then discount received. Discount received is a business related, so that ignore it. Business and admissible income. And then bad debts recovered, not written off earlier year. So not written off. So bad debts recovered, if bad debts recovered is given, that is admissible or business income. But the bad debts recovered, not written off earlier, not allowed as a deduction earlier. Okay, so not written off earlier, it means not allowed as a deduction in the earlier year, so that it is tax free income, so that consider in a less items. 800 rupees is to be deducted. And then sundry receipts. So sundry receipts, is like other incomes anta. So other incomes is always business related, so that ignore it. And dividend, so dividend is not business income, it is tax free income. Why it is not business income? Dividend is considered as a, you see, dividend from a domestic company is tax free. So the dividend, if it is not received from the domestic company, if dividend is given in the question, you should consider that as a non-business income or tax-free business income, so that deduct from the net profit. And the total of profit and loss account is 7 lakh rupees. Okay, so now let me explain the answer. So here is the answer. So first you have to write the heading, computation of taxable income from business. Then the name of assessee. The name of assessee is Mr. J. Residential status is a resident. Previous year is 2018-19 and assessment year is 2019-20. And now, so we'll go to net answer. So first particular columns are three, particulars, amount, amount. So now, first in all the answers, you should write the net profit at the starting. Net profit, that to as per profit and loss account. So as per profit and loss account, net profit is 5,36,000. Okay, then add items. So there are five add items as I explained before. Okay, so here, so add it, in add items we have five things. One is inadmissible expenses debited in profit and loss account. Inadmissible expenses means, so that expenses does not considered as a business expenses as per Income Tax Act 1961. Okay, so inadmissible expenses andre avu business expenses anta consider madilla. Income Tax Act prakara avu business expenses alla. So adrinda avu en madbeku, naavu inadmissible expenses enadru debit side record madidre profit and loss account alli, adanna net profit ge add madbeku. Avaga namge real age eshtu business income anta gotagutte. Okay, so first thing is interest on capital, that is 12,000, income tax 16,000, charity which means donation 8,000, and extension of building 20,000. So already we observed in the question, so those items are recorded here. And then, so business income, second point is business incomes not credited to profit and loss account. Not credited means profit and loss account alli credit side aakilla. In el kotirtare adjustment alli kotirtare, but in the question no adjustments is there, so that our, you know, business incomes not credited is nil. Then overvaluation of opening stock, opening stock e kotilla, in overvaluation alli nil. So undervaluation of closing stock, even closing stock also is not given in the question, so taken as nil. Then notional loss, it is not there, so nil. So total add items 656,000. Now go to, we'll go to less items. So less items allo kuda 5 items. So as we know, 5 items. So first is, first one is admissible expenses not debited to profit and loss account. Not debited, so again not debited means, so here the amount or those items will be given in the adjustments. If it is not debited, they may be given in adjustments. If it is given in the adjustments, so just you need to deduct from the net profit, or else you need to consider that in a less items. Yavde undu admissible expenses anna debit side kodidira, adjustment alli kottidare andre adanna neen en madabeku, less items alli tagobeku. So illi yavde reetiyadanta antadilla, because adjustments is not given. And next, second item bandibito non-business and tax-free incomes credited in profit and loss account. Credited in andre already mentioned in the profit and loss account under credit side. If any non-business incomes, if any tax-free incomes is credited, just deduct from the net profit. So yenen ide anta do, interest on government securities 11,200, and bad debts recovered. So bad debts recovered anta matra kotidre ignore madta idde. Illi bad debts recovered but disallowed earlier, so that it is considered as tax free 800 rupees. Now next, dividends. So dividends is also a tax free income, so that considered here 16,000. And next bandaga, overvaluation of opening closing stock illa, undervaluation of opening stock illa, and notional profit too illa. So if so after this, so that you have to total the less items, the total of that is 28,000. 28,000. If you deduct this 28,000 from the net profit as well as add items, you'll get the amount of rupees 5,64,000. 5,64,000 is what taxable income from business. So this is what the solution, this is the final answer, that is taxable income from business is 5,64,000. Hope you understand. Thank you all. Jai Shri Gurudev.